Every time I do this one, it's a little bit on the emotional side. So, welcome. You will only get to hear my voice today. Do you know why? Her voice has taken a vacation. So it's probably with Matt in Belize, sunning itself.
Costa Rica,
sunning itself and living the life,
yeah.
Whilst you are serving everyone here Illumina's magic mantra Monday. So let's see who's here. So Lila's had a bit of a sore throat and congestion and all that, so her voice is Zaba, oh, that's Gordana. Gordana, welcome. Matt, namaste, beautiful souls. Natalia, that's right. Natalia, welcome. I think you've been with us before, haven't you?
Many times.
V-E cat. Oh, or is it V-cat? V-cat. Wicked. Wicked V-cat. Welcome, Vikat. You are most welcome. Dragana, welcome. Madeline, honor.
She's a friend of mine.
Friend of yours? Excellent. Welcome, Madeline. Welcome. Clara Apollo. What a name, Clara Apollo. Love it. Clara, welcome. Rachel. Rachel was with us in our concert in Dulwich. And Gordana was there as well, and a few others who will join us probably were as with us in that concert. Beautiful concert. We had chai. We had chai in the end. We had Kundalini yoga with Natalie. We had a gong bath, and then we had a concert Illumina style, and it was very, very very special. Every concert is special, but this one was very special. Mm. Mm. So thank you for joining us, everyone. Whoever was there. Oh, you need healing? Try last month's mantra. Yeah.
Yeah.
Exactly. Get well soon, Lila. Sounds lovely. Hope to hear more soon. Yeah.
Thank
Much
you.
Love.
Thank you.
Yeah, she's been trooping through her classes, and she had her gong bath evening in a yoga studio, the Shala, in here in South London. And it's usually 30 people. It just packs out basically in that room, and she trooped through it with her, with our wonderful friend Anna, who might join us later, who helped her out. Mm. So, sending healing thoughts to Lila. Yeah,
mm-hmm.
Yeah. So today, because I'm on my own, I'll need you guys to help me. Saturday was lovely. Yes, Emily, welcome. So I'll be needing your help and your energy to complete the live and keep sending comments so that there's plenty of things to bounce off of. And we will definitely hold Lila's voice in the circle today, even if it's Kali Mantra. There's great healing in every mantra, so mm. I'm sure it's gonna blast through any viruses in there.
Mm.
It's gonna be an antivirus.
Mm.
So Gurdana is saying, so sorry mm-hmm. about your voice, Lila. Hope you get better soon. Sending you healing energy. Yeah. So it's just her voice that's kind of just now it's recovering, but it needs a little bit more coaxing.
Mm.
But apart from that, you're feeling pretty okay, aren't you?
Obviously, a bit of congestion.
Bit of congestion. So who's been chanting the Kali Mantra during the week? Tell us all about it. We'd love to hear it. And which one of you is the amazing champion who's been doing this and who's been connecting with Kali every day? So type away, tell us all about it. What's your experience been like? Warm salty water is good. Yes,
mm.
It is indeed warm salty water. It's a good advice actually.
Mm. Mm.
And if anyone's been chanting, I know Rachel, no, who was it? Lindy Lu said she was chanting the Kali Mantra every day. Right. So if and when Lindy joins us, she may want to tell us all about her experience with it. And I'm not chanting it, to be quite honest, because I have so many, well, I'm doing a kind of a discipline, which I have been doing for the last three years now, that I chant every day. I'm doing Vedic astrology, each planet has a specific mantra attached to it and has a specific result. So I'm doing incredible, humongous amounts of mantras. There's a certain number of mantras that you do to attain a certain level of proficiency in that planet's energy and to really connect deeply with that planet's energy. So it takes, let's just say, it's a lot and lots and lots of repetition. So that takes up, my mantra time each morning. So Kali Mantra, I have done Kali Mantra in the past and I've had great results with it. Especially regarding the egoic behaviors. Look who's here.
Mm-hmm.
Uma, Lawrence, Laurence. It's not even Lawrence, it's Laurence. Laurence is with us. Laurence is a very...
That's a new name.
New name. Uma is her new name. Laurence is a old friend of ours from way back And there was a time when she used to spend every Christmas with us. So maybe this is a sign. Laurence, are you going to spend Christmas with us this time? It'd be amazing. So Matt's saying, feel the warmth from Costa Rica. Mm, imagine
yes.
you are on the beautiful beach
mm.
with the waves clearing everything for you. That's
beautiful.
Wonderful. That's wonderful. I did it once. Oh, you lazy sluggard. You did it once. You did it once. Good. Well done. Once is better than none. No, really, I mean it. It's really, you know, once is better than none. But try and make a practice. It actually doesn't take long. These are short mantras. We keep very short chantable mantras for the Mondays because there can be some amazingly long mantras that just huge sentence that you just then repeat. So we keep them short because it's to encourage all of us to take it home and repeat every day. Just once. It'll take you 2 minutes. Even five would be too much, 2-3 minutes to go through 108 times. And you're done for the day. So try and do it, guys. Try and do it every day if you can. Rachel did it once at least. The rest of us hang our heads in shame. Oh, Matt was doing it. I was doing the mantra each morning. As part of the healing, I am doing with various, yes, indigenous plant medicines. It has been a powerful way to focus on connecting with my ego and seeing what is in here ready to be transformed. Yes, fantastic. That's exactly it. Exactly it. So well done, Matt. Well done, Matt. Welcome, Bindu. Like your matching. Oh, yeah. Matching outfits. If I just stay like this, then we're totally matching outfits. Hair. Which one of us is which? Maybe we'll start looking like each other eventually. Maybe we already do and we don't even realize it and everyone else thinks, oh my God, they look like brother and sister. So, should we get chanting? Yeah, let's do this. Before we start chanting, I'd like to remind you or all of us of the mantra Om KREEM KALIKAYE NAMAHA. Om KREEM KALIKAYE NAMAHA. Emily saying, I'm sitting with the full moon shining above me outside the window. Yeah, beautiful, beautiful. So this mantra, again, for those of you who are new today, who did not join us last time, we will be doing this, we do theme month. So this month is the theme of Kali. We're taking a Kali mantra and we're doing that repeatedly for the entire month. And Kali is a very, very powerful energy to work with in terms of breaking up egoic structures. You know what Kali is good for? If you know you have to change, but somehow change is not happening, do this mantra. We all know, we all know, if we listen to our conscience, if we listen to our that deep inner voice, we all know that we need to change in that one area, right? We know that. We know it. But what happens is that some kind of hijack happens, some kind of kidnapping happens, where our good intentions are just swept away and we find ourselves behaving just like in the old way. And then we go away and think, oh my God, when will I change? When will this change for me, this behavior? Why do I behave like this? When will it change? Do the Kali mantra. And I promise you, it's like a drain cleaner. It will start breaking up all the trapped hair and the gunk and the muck in your consciousness. So, something to think about. On that note, let's close our eyes and just imagine. Take a deep breath in and out. And another one in, deep breath in and out. And another one in. Keep your eyes closed. And just imagine that you are sitting in the yoga position in your astral body at the bottom of the ocean. Nothing can harm you. You are at the bottom of the ocean. And the water is just in you and around you. You're part of the element. There's no need to breathe in that state. You are perfectly in stillness. If the ocean is a little bit difficult to imagine, you can imagine outer space. You are in the deep reaches of space, sitting there in your astral body, in a cross-legged position, in a yoga position, totally in tune with the frequencies of this universe. In this state, everything is available to you, and you are available to everything. There is no resistance, because there is no need to feel unsafe. You are invulnerable in your astral body. Everything passes through you. You are totally transparent, fully in tune with the rhythms and the pulse of everything around you. And here, bring to mind something in your earthly body's life, a behavior or something that you are struggling to change, and you can from that state see very clearly what needs to change and that it's easy to change. And now, as we chant this mantra, try to connect to that state of non-resistance and total harmony with your surroundings. KALIKAYE NAMAHA. 1, 2, 1, 2. Om KREEM KALIKAYE NAMAHA. 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 KALIKAYE NAMAHA. Om KREEM 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 KALIKAYE NAMAHA. KALIKAYE NAMAHA. Om KREEM KALIKAYE NAMAHA. Om KREEM KALIKAYE NAMAHA. KALIKAYE NAMAHA OM KREEM 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 KALIKAYE NAMAHA KALIKAYE NAMAHA OM KREEM 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 KALIKAYE NAMAHA KALIKAYE NAMAHA OM KREEM 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 KALIKAYE NAMAHA KALIKAYE NAMAHA OM KREEM 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 KALIKAYE NAMAHA KALIKAYE NAMAHA OM KREEM 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 KALIKAYE NAMAHA KALIKAYE NAMAHA OM KREEM 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 KALIKAYE NAMAHA KALIKAYE NAMAHA OM KREEM 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 KALIKAYE NAMAHA KALIKAYE NAMAHA OM KREEM 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 KALIKAYE NAMAHA KALIKAYE NAMAHA OM KREEM 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 KALIKAYE NAMAHA KALIKAYE NAMAHA OM KREEM 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 KALIKAYE NAMAHA KALIKAYE NAMAHA OM KREEM 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 KALIKAYE NAMAHA KALIKAYE NAMAHA OM KREEM 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 KALIKAYE NAMAHA KALIKAYE NAMAHA OM KREEM 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 KALIKAYE NAMAHA KALIKAYE NAMAHA OM KREEM 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 KALIKAYE NAMAHA KALIKAYE NAMAHA OM KREEM 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 KALIKAYE NAMAHA KALIKAYE NAMAHA OM KREEM 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 KALIKAYE NAMAHA KALIKAYE NAMAHA OM KREEM 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 KALIKAYE NAMAHA KALIKAYE NAMAHA OM KREEM 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 KALIKAYE NAMAHA KALIKAYE NAMAHA OM KREEM 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 KALIKAYE NAMAHA KALIKAYE NAMAHA OM KREEM KALIKAYE NAMAHA Wow. Yeah, it felt strange to just do it by myself. But it was very powerful. It's a powerful chant, it's a powerful mantra. So as you're coming out of it in your own time, let us know in the comments, let us know what your journey was in it, what you experienced, if you got any insights or if you had an experience, anything during the chanting, let us know in the comments. Gordana is doing some emojis of gratitude. Yeah, powerful chant, huh? So remember, guys, that every time when you do a chanting, when you repeat a chant, don't just finish it and then just go. You know, sometimes we have to do that, but try and make sure that you sit for 2-3 minutes afterwards, 5 minutes, and really let the mantra sink in into the silence, because at that point the mind is very quiet. So let the mantra sink in and really let it do its work inside of you. And you know, of try and avoid just moving on to the next thing you have to do in your day. Try and create a bit more of a ritual around it. Mm-hmm. It's very, very important, because it's really not the mantra that the mantra does the bulk of the work, but the mantra also needs, trying to sow seeds in tough soil, dry, tough stones in that soil, it's very difficult. But if we have soft soil, if we have soil that is all mulched and it's soft and it's non-resistant, then when the seeds go in, they will go deeper and they will sprout quicker. So remember, your job is, the mantra's job is to go into you, but your job is to create a fertile environment inside of you, to let the mantra sink in. And that can only happen if we are allowing ourselves to be silent afterwards and just sit for a while quietly with yourself and experience the effects of that chant of that time. And you know, that's when the mantra can do its work. So Matt, I really love the process of holding my hands out in a cup in front of me. Feels like I am asking and receiving the energy. It feels a little like submission. Yeah, it's nice. You just hold your hands like that, and that's also lovely. It's a mudra. It's a lovely mudra to do. Very powerful. Yes, indeed. Anna, hello, Anna. Anna. Yes, powerful, but also very gentle at the same time. Felt a strong sense of clarity at the end about nothing in particular. Just a beautiful feeling of clearing, yes. Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's very good, because clarity about something is clarity of mind, which we all sorely need in this day and age. But clarity is a state of being. Mm. You understand? Clarity, I have clarity about that issue, about that divorce, about that job, about my boss, about this, about that, about my money. That's clarity of the mind. An insight has come, an education has happened. Then you have human beings on this earth who are just clear. It's their state of being. They are just clear human beings. So it is. So what Anna is experiencing is that clarity. At least that's my interpretation of her comment. Very light and joyful chanting it. After the chant, deep silence within. Yes. Mm. Yeah, absolutely. Anna, let us know if that's what, if what I just said about clarity is what you feel that you are trying to convey. Very light and joyful chanting. Yeah. Yeah, it's a strange one. It seems to have, like, there are other mantras that we have done that seems to have similar effect on everyone. And this is one of those mantras which seems to have a very unique effects for each person. Mm. Mm. Some people are finding it light and joyful. Others are, you know, find, you know, like for me, I wouldn't describe it as light and joyful. Although, I know exactly what you mean when you say it was light and joyful. Do you know what I mean? It's this is, we're all discovering the properties of this mantra together as we chant it, you know. Powerfully clearing. Could have sat in the stillness, yeah, for a long time. Indeed, yes. It's always a struggle to get the live moving forward. Otherwise, we would just love to sit for 10 minutes, no problem, mm-hmm. you know. Anna's saying, yeah, that resonates. Yeah, it's true. Katembo Rafael, what a great name, Katembo. I am new here. What is Illumina's mean? Illumina means in Sanskrit there's a word Ujjval. Ujjval means lighted up, illuminated, but not illuminated, not lighted up like the moon, which is just the moon by itself, he cannot reflect anything. It's a dead world. And it's there for a very specific purpose, and someone built it, and that's a whole different conversation. However, we're talking about illumination that comes out of our dear sun goddess. She is self-illuminating, and that is what Illumina, it's a Spanish word for that same property of illumination. So, welcome, Katembo. I hope I'm saying it correctly. And hope you are able to chant with us. And if not, then you can always watch the live later on. It'll be on our page. Hit like on the page and you can always join us again. It's every Monday, 8:30 p.m. for those of you who are new with us. 8:30 p.m. we are sat in front of this beautiful phone of ours and talking with you guys, communicating, connecting with everyone. And we are forming a little community, an oasis of chanting mantras in the comfort of our homes, especially in the winter now. it's very cozy. And getting the benefits. So, welcome Heather, where have you been? Heather, welcome. Andraj? I don't know how that Z would be pronounced, but I hope I'm saying it correctly. Welcome, brother. Welcome. We are about to wrap up, finish off. And if anyone else has anything to share about the chanting session today, you can do so now. Meanwhile, something very exciting is happening on the 1st of December. 1st of December. So those of you who've just joined us, Lila is not talking. Usually she is equally vocal because she has lost her voice. She has a bit of cold congestion and all that. So she is unable to speak at the moment. But her presence is illuminating all of us. Her presence and love is illuminating all of us. 1st of December, ask. What is happening, Anam? Just go ahead and just ask. What is happening, Anam? And then I'll tell you. Okay, yeah. So, what's happening on the 1st of December is a concert, Illumina style. And there ain't no other style except the Illumina style for Illumina. So we are in East London this time. We were in South London just this Saturday gone. East London in a place called Joy Yoga. It's a Kundalini yoga space run by the beautiful Sat Shakti Kaur, our friend who was here as a guest on our live a few months ago. And she's a beautiful, inspirational lady who's a founder of this. It was her dream for a long time and amazing. She finally found a property and it's thriving and it's just fantastic watching her go from an idea years ago and really, really like sticking with it. And she used to just hire spaces and do it, and then that stopped working, and this was just so many, she had to adapt so many ways, and finally she has a fabulous space. So we are proud to be there sharing our music in that space with all you beautiful people who are going to turn up and going to buy the ticket right after this live. You are going to do that. If not, if you're not in London, then what will happen is that I shall hypnotize you into sharing a post to your London friends to go and immediately book the tickets to our concert. Concert. Concert.
Very good.
Concert.
Very good.
Poor Lila, sending love and healing. Yeah. Sending love and healing. So that is date coming up. Please keep that in mind. Please, we depend on you guys to share with your friends, because it's not, you won't see our posters on the on the tube. You won't see big ads in on TV. Illumina live. It's not gonna happen. So we need our community. Huh?
One day.
One day.
One day.
We one day that'll happen. But it's not happening just yet. So please share with your friends. They say these guys are alive, and those of you who have been with us, you know how amazing an experience it is. So it will be lovely to have people experiencing that. Then we are, so this is at Joy Yoga, the 21st of December, winter solstice. We are doing an event. It is our own event. It's a, what is it? It's a
cacao
ceremony followed by a winter solstice dance to cleanse, clear, energize, rejuvenate, let go, express, and just feel our inner divinity flowing through our bodies. And the great thing about that is it's to live drumming. So me, myself and our percussionist, the very awesome Tad, incredibly talented drummer, percussionist, will be providing you guys with thumping live drums. I mean, wow. Those of you who have, we've done these before, and whoa. If you want to dance, you want to dance to live drums on the winter solstice. Imagine that. So we'll do a powerful, beautiful cacao ceremony into the dance, and then after the dance, we're going to do some, there'll be a chanting concert after that. And if you know anything about Illumina concerts, they are not just us two, it's everyone singing together and opening up to a divine flow of the universe together. So it's very much a shared experience. So again, keep these events are on our page. You can go to the events page and check them out there on our website as well if you want to book. All the booking links are there. So any one of you who is meant to be there will be there. Any one of your friends who is meant to be there will be there. So thank you for sharing and spreading the word. And thank you for listening. So Gordana is saying December. Yeah, 1st December and 21st December. Exactly. On that note, yet another Monday Live with you beautiful, beautiful, powerful beings, each one of you. We want to remind you that your voice is very powerful. Now, that may not register in the deeper sense, but we do want to remind you that you are divinity itself. You're not a spark of divinity. You're not a part of divinity. That is all separation thinking. That's not how it is. that is not accurate. You're not a spark of divinity. You are it. You're it. You are it. You are divine. You are divine. You know what I mean? You're not a part of divinity. None of that nonsense. Mental. You are divine. You are divinity. And if that realization can go in a little bit, what would our voice be then?
Mm.
A part. It would be the expression of that divinity. So do not forget what you have to say, what you are thinking, what you're saying is all divine. So rest in that. It's all divine. You don't have to constantly be self-criticizing, oh my God, what kind of person am I? And toxic thinking. Just let go of all that. Understand your divinity deeply. Understand it on a deeper level. Commit to that. It will take years, but commit to it. So that is why we are here, to understand and express our divinity. Yes? On that note, guys, thank you so much. We love you all. And we shall see you next Monday. Bye. How can I become a member of it? I don't understand what you mean by that. You just put it in the comments with a bit more explanation what you mean. And I think he means Illuminati. So, yeah, if you want to become a member of the Illuminati, I can put you in touch with a great guy I know. Just PM me. Take care, guys. Lots of love. Bye for now.